Dr. Jennifer Rhodes, and I'm the founder of Visual Arts Reimagine and Rapport Relationships. And this week we are talking about my gallery experiences, because as most of you know, I am a psychologist by training. And although my family has been involved in the visual art world and I love artists and I love art, I'm not necessarily on the side of the artist, nor am I on the side of the gallery side. I am technically considered an art collector. And I have to say that the majority of my gallery visits in the New York City area, and most recently in Montreal, have definitely not been great experiences from the collector's standpoint. And that is simply because most gallery owners do not take the opportunity to actually engage with someone when someone walks into their gallery. And so sometimes a gallery is individually owned, and sometimes it would be a gallerist, or sometimes it's their assistant. And regardless of who is actually in that gallery at that particular time, there is not a whole heck of a lot of training going on about how to talk to your potential art collectors and to figure out how to grow their list. So I have to say, and out of the 20 galleries I have probably been to in the past 8 weeks alone, only 2 galleries even asked for my email and even asked for my name. So that's a pretty low percentage. And I've been just walking into galleries that had work that I might be actually interested in purchasing. And the reason why we're talking about this, at least from my perspective, is that you as the artist need to understand that these gallery owners don't have some kind of magic to be able to sell your work better than you do. For some of you, going down a traditional path is going to make sense, and finding the right gallery is going to be a huge break in your career. But for many artists these days and age, it's going to be your social media following, and it's going to be your Instagram that helps you find the collectors who really love your work. So I'm going to talk a little bit more about my experience with my gallery visit in Montreal that I didn't love. And then I'm going to tell you about a gallerist who is located in the Hamptons, who I really love her approach, that I think that you should become familiar with her, her gallery, and put her on radar to see if you or someone that you know is a potential fit for her. So a couple weekends ago, I went to Montreal for a dance festival, and part of my time there was actually just walking around, and I ended up in an arts district that had a lot of galleries. And it was a Friday afternoon, and so some of the galleries were having openings. And so I just love to just walk in. And a lot of times when galleries have artwork that is, you know, sitting on the street or has a window that's sitting on the street, it does bring people into the gallery who might not, you know, necessarily be there or might be from out of town. So I definitely walked into a couple of these galleries, and I immediately did not want to be there because of the attitude of the assistants that were in the galleries. They didn't ask my name, they didn't ask why I was there, they didn't ask if I knew the artist, and in one case I did know the artist, and they didn't seem all too concerned about making a sale. What they were doing was spending time on their iPad and talking to each other. So in this one gallery, there were 4 assistants, and I know nothing about them, I know nothing. In further detail about the artist, all I know is that I don't want to buy any work from this particular gallery. Prior to my trip to Montreal, I went out to go visit the Parish Art Museum in the Hamptons, and I was referred to a woman named Cynthia who runs the Artist Study. And the Artist Study was opened a couple years ago by Cynthia, who was a well-known gallerist in the area. And I walked in, and she was actually in the process of talking to a well-known Russian artist about whether or not she was going to take his work. And I immediately walked in, and she had her 3 beautiful children in the gallery, and I felt like I walked into her living room. And although it might not have been the greatest time to have a conversation with a potential collector, she made the time. So not only did I learn that she has a phenomenal eye for artwork, but I got to learn about her personality, and I got to hear a little bit about what her visions are for her future business. She made me feel welcome. She did not rush me. She collected my name and email address, and she seemed really interested in getting to know me as a potential future buyer for her work. And I have to say that there is definitely work that she was showing there that I was more than interested in going back to visit and potentially purchasing the next time. So in terms of the top list of gallerists that I've had interaction with in the last 8 weeks, I would probably go all the way out of my way to drive to the Hamptons just to go see Cynthia at the Artist Study. So if you have not been to the Hamptons this weekend, with the 4th of July coming up, it's probably a good time to go and visit. There are a number of artists, including some famous artists, young artists coming from LA to do an exhibition in Montauk. And I really just think that you should get out of your comfort zone and leave your area and just go see how different gallerists run their business. Because I guarantee you there's going to be a really big shift in gallerists who are capable of making it because they really care about the artist and the work that they do. And gallerists that are going to be reinventing their business approach in the next few years. So if you'd like to know more information about Cynthia, or perhaps for me to make an introduction for you, send an email to me at jennifer@visualartsreimagined.com, or send an email to Netanel, our bar fellow, at netanel@visualartsreimagined.com. And as always, if you like this video, please feel free to comment, share your stories. If there are galleries in Brooklyn, Manhattan, other parts of New York City that you really, really love or have shown your work, please, please, please share those names so that we can come visit and we can support those amazing gallery owners. And if you are about to show your work and you have an upcoming opening, please let us know so that we can help promote you. Please share this video. And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to email us. And stay tuned for our video next week, where we're going to be exploring more about creativity, business, entrepreneurship, and kind of just supporting all of you artists making the living and doing the work that you love. Thanks for watching. Bye.